coming in today. I know it's been tough to get here.
Sure, yeah.
So this session is really an intake, and an intake looks very different from normal counseling sessions.
Mm-hmm.
And there are a couple of things that I want to just talk to you about, and then you'll have a chance to tell me what's been going on for you.
Okay.
I do tend to jot notes. You can probably see I've got lots of blanks on here.
Sure.
I'm going to fill some of them in, but I'm not going to fill all of them in. And then really this is, for me, a memory jogger than anything else. We'll be talking for about 45 minutes to an hour or so. And we'll just, it'll be as much like a conversation as I can make it. What we talk about is confidential, and there are limits to confidentiality. If I think you're going to hurt yourself or somebody else, then I have an obligation to let another authority know. And the same goes if I think that there is a child or an elder that's in danger as well. But we would talk about what that means and what would need to be done about it.
Okay.
And let's see what else. I have sort of a checklist in the back of my head. I got that. Confidentiality, time. You're absolutely welcome to ask questions as we go to. And I just want you to know I'm a what you see is what you get kind of person. If I have a question, I'll ask. If I have a concern, I'll let you know. And I invite you to do the same, and as to the best of your ability, whatever you would like to do around that. What else would be helpful to you as we get started?
I just want to start kind of anxious.
Yeah, a lot of people are kind of nervous about this very beginning. And I'll just acknowledge that, you know, here I'm a perfect stranger, or an imperfect stranger.
Yeah.
And I'm going to be asking you pretty personal questions to get us started.
Right.
So I already have some information because you filled out some demographics and things like that before you even came. So I'm not even going to go to some of the things that are on here. It's just, this is also a sheet for me to fill out after we're done. And just so that you know, the things that I'm writing on here are as close to verbatim as I can get, because that's going to be helpful in the end, too. I'm not writing, well, what she says is this, but what she really means is, okay? Just tell me a little bit about what's been going on for you.
Well, I guess I'm just, I feel like I'm a little, I'm anxious a lot.
Okay.
I get nervous a lot. I'm nervous right now because I just feel like I don't know if I'm ready to start talking about everything that I feel like maybe I should talk about. But it's been, I guess maybe it just, I have a lot of things that I think about all the time that just come into my head all the time that make me feel sad or make me just want to like, push everybody away or push everything out.
So there's anxiety that's going on for you and sadness. And also wanting to push people away. You said push people out, and
yeah.
I said push people away. Is that different?
No, not
about
that.
Okay. So then, tell me more about feeling anxious. How long has that been going on?
I don't know. I think I've always been a little anxious. I think it just gets worse. The older I get, and like the more responsibilities that I have, I guess like my childhood wasn't that made me anxious, or there was just a lot of things that happened that made me nervous, or and I don't think ever, I don't think I really got a lot of like, comfort or something.
Okay, that's helpful for me to know. So, the anxiety's been going on for a long time, as long as you can remember.
Yeah.
Remember when it might have started?
Well, I used to worry a lot about my mom, because she, I guess for the first few years of my life, I guess we were pretty happy, but sometime around when my dad left, my mom started using drugs, and so I think I just worried about her a lot, because she would, I think I ended up taking care of her a lot too, just because she would, whatever she was taking, she would make her tired, and she slept a lot, or passed out, or whatever.
Mm-hmm. So about how old were you when that was going on?
I don't know, between like 7 to like, I think around like 7 was when my dad left, and then things just kept escalating from there, and like it was like the older I got, the more she knew I was capable of taking care of her, and she needed, like, so it was almost like she like depended on me to take care of her.
Well, it would make sense that you would have anxiety then, because that's a lot of responsibility for a kid.
Yeah.
And it never really went away. And so you've got anxiety, and you also said some sadness.
Yeah.
Tell me about the sadness.
I don't know. I think it's more of like an empty sadness, kind of, just because I almost like I don't feel a lot. Like, no, when I'm thinking about it right now, I feel like I don't feel a lot about everything. My life just was what it was. But I still feel like sometimes I'm sad that, like, maybe I'm just sad that I didn't have a child, like the childhood that other people had, or, and I feel like, but there's nothing I can do to change it, and there's nothing I can do about it, and it just makes me feel stuck, I wish everything had been different, but none of it was, and so I have to live with it, and I just don't really know how to do that anymore, how am I supposed to have normal relationships, or like the ones that you see like on TV and stuff. I just don't know I don't really know how to do that.
Yeah, so you've got, I'm going to kind of tease out little parts of what you've just said, because that's a lot. And I apologize, I just got distracted a minute ago because I was hearing another sound coming from somewhere and I can't figure out what it was. I don't know if you heard it too, but
yeah.
I got a little distracted, but I was still paying attention to what you were saying. So the anxiety and then the sadness, and the sadness is really more about feeling empty. And also stuck, and wondering if you would always feel this way, and then also comparing your experience to what you've seen in the media and on TV.
Right. Yeah.
And there's not much of a match.
Right.
And so I also wonder, is which is more, the anxiety or the sadness? Which is,
I don't know. I don't think I can pick. I think maybe just, I want to say the anxiety, but that's just because I'm feeling nervous right now.
Yeah.
So I'm leaning more towards that. And but I don't know.
Okay.
I mean, because I don't know. I go to work and I do things.
So it's not impacting you so much that you don't go to work.
Right.
And yet, it sounds like it's always there.
Yeah, okay. And I have a hard time, I think,
Like, I don't, I think I want to connect with other people, but I just don't, or I just can't,
mm-hmm.
or
mm-hmm.
I guess I don't.
Okay.
So what ends up happening is that you do get to work. You're not you're able to do your work, but maybe you're not connecting with people the way that you want to.
Yeah.
Well, there because you've talked about anxiety, because you've talked about depression, there's a kind of a I have a list in the back of my head that I want to go through so that I can just help us figure out what it really is translating to. Then let's look at sleep. Because depression can impact sleep and so can anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about your sleep.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I sleep enough. I stay up a lot. Because it's just, I don't know. I stay up and I read things or watch things and like it just keeps my mind busy, and then I just
mm-hmm.
can't really fall asleep.
It's hard to fall asleep?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I just wait until I like
mm-hmm.
until I'm just so tired that I can't.
So you have difficulty with falling asleep because you've got a lot of chatter.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And how restful is your sleep then?
Not really. I mean, sometimes it is. If I'm tired enough, but sometimes, I don't know, sometimes I dream a lot or I toss and turn or
mm-hmm.
something.
Okay. And